Hi, meneer Zwitten, en welkom back to the Vanilla Minecraft server. It has been a long, long, long while since I last recorded an episode on this server. That's because I wanted to make the episodes like tutorials, but in Vanilla Minecraft that does not really work. So I'm giving this another try. And I will show you a few things that I've been doing around here and things that still need to be done, like finishing the walls on the outside, for example. Okay, let's change view. Okay, so this is my humble castle. It is not only just a castle, as you can see, there is a clock at the front. And I can hear some zombies somewhere making noise. Never mind that one. So this is my castle. At the center of this, there is a big gold farm and a huge two-tower structure with a mob farm. At the moment, it's all disabled. That's because go down here, control and AFK room. Needs a bit more furnishing. But as you can see, we got our switch for the slime farm. Let's put the hut on. So that is off now. Now it's back on. The clock and the two pillars. So if you turn this on, for example, the left pillar will be working, the right one will be disabled all the time. So as you can see, let's move a little bit back. We may see some things spawn. It's still daytime, so there should be plenty of things to spawn. Can we see something? Maybe at the back. We can hear them at least. Well, these are two pillars. The clock is running up top there and enabling the water from time to time and alternating between them so that I don't produce too much lag when both of these are running. Let me quickly switch on. Oh, go down. Switch on the second one. There we go. Okay. Let's see if it's working. No, there we go. That pillar didn't have a lot of time for mobs to spawn, but it drained them, flooded them out of the system, and after a while, that one will go, then that one. So alternating not both at the same time. And come on, it doesn't take that long. Anyway, the gold farm up there has a hole in the middle of this huge water platform, and every big man is there we go. It's pushed to the center and drop down the center of this and fall to the death down below. Would they have seen me now? And there we go. The water flows and down they go. So this is a huge room and to hide all of this, I built a huge castle around it. It has a hallway completely around, and in the corners there is a tower. The tower functions as a big room where I can put stuff. For example, on this side, here I got the item elevator for the drops and a sorting system on top of this that you can just saw a slime ball pass by. On top of this, there's a sorting system that puts the items in these Now, at the moment, I have this set up as a water stream going over some hoppers, but that does not work 100%. Sometimes the drops, there we go, jump over and land is this in this last chest. As you can see, slime balls shouldn't be here, should be there. But anyway, we can take this out if it's something that we need sorted and just drop them in the corner. And that goes with a dropper elevator. Makes a lot of noise. Here I got my simple storage system. Not everything is right here. Some are still outside because I got too much dirt and too much cobble, too much stone to fit in here. Of course, I can put more here, but I'm not sure if I want to do that. But it's possible. Make a big storage here for cobble and dirt, for example. This is a Mega Smelter 9000, more or less. It is based on a design by Generic B. I need to put the chest in the middle here. There's no way to easily cover these hoppers without blocking them, putting redstone on top and so on, because as you can see there is redstone there. If I put a block there, some things will stop working. But you put the input there, fuel here, and the output is this chest. There is currently some glass. And here is a chart of how much one item will burn. Now we are at the back of this massive structure, and here I got a maze. It's not a labyrinth. So you simply enter here and run around, serpentine around, and we'll end up in the center eventually. It's a long, long run, but there is no dead ends and so on. So just a snake maze, just for fun. Most of this was flattened, and I've even terraformed the mountains around here so that it looks more or less natural. As you can see, there is a very industrial looking gradient there, but I've covered most things with grass and trees and so on to make it look nice. On the smaller hills, it's not that obvious, but over there was a big hill with a small cut in, and there is very low hills, so these don't look as industrial as that one. And there I got some more chests from digging this thing out and so on. That's my secret stock. Okay. The next room here is a room with simply a glass shaft where normally villagers will drop down and iron golems. But we are upgraded to the last snapshot, and for some reason a lot of the villagers disappeared in my villager iron golem farm up there, and the thing is no longer working and no longer producing iron. So we'll have to refill those villagers, rebreed them for this to work again. And if we continue this way, there is nothing more, I think. Yep. Just the first thing that I did here was to make some kind of art gallery. So I still need to make something here in the middle. fountain, or maybe even rebuild maybe the dinosaur that Ito had outside of his potion shop. The thing looked really neat. Maybe I will rebuild it here. It's not that tall, but I think it will look nice. And that's strange. I used to have two of these flowers also here. Now they're gone. Strange. Snapshots can be buggy sometimes, so who knows what happened. I will turn this off before I forget. Turn off the clock. Leave it on. There are still a lot of temporary things like this hole to go down the floor. And if we go up here, as you can see, a lot of stone went into this building. We come to this floor, and these are two lines for the towers, and one line to enable the clock. As you can see, this is what happens. Three blocks. There's a redstone torch over there, or a switch, I don't remember, that will push a signal through, and with an AND gate and the signal of the clock of the tower switch down below will power this block or this block, so that one of the towers gets flooded. And here you can see the simple sorting system, but I will have to change this and put some hoppers between this, because it's not working as it's supposed to do. There we go. Very cool to watch, but not 100% working. Okay, let's go back down. And let's take our second way down. So this is a three piston door and ladder system. Very fast and completely hidden, except for the switch, of course. I will change that to a flip-flop system, where I can push a button down here and one up there, so when I close this and I come back up through this way, I don't have to destroy the piston. This way I got my slime system. As you can see, there are two slime chunks, one there and one here. There's also one behind that wall and one further down, but this is more than enough. They get killed or divided by the lava, the big ones. But here you can see three floors, and on this side as well, that can get flooded by the water above these blocks. But I can enable this to get a higher rate of spawning at the mob farm. From this, I got a lot of slime blocks for Mark's pit. In here, they don't swim anymore. Oh, they do. Buggy. Okay, the Slimes 2 and 2 will swim up, will drown, and the other ones will drown below. As you can see, that one goes down, that one as well. That one should go down as well. Doesn't want to. But they all will drown. The slime balls will be picked up by the hoppers. And something crashed, I think. And welcome back. There was some strange error on the screen saying that something didn't have an item and simply crashed Minecraft. Okay, so the droppers will pick up the slime balls, and there is a elevator going up here, putting slime blocks in the stream, and everything will be transported this way and going towards the item elevator. This is the way to the normal spawner, and every item will be pushed inside of the water stream right here. And if we continue this way, long ass way, this is where the iron golems get killed right now. Like I said, nothing happens here because it's broken. Silly Minecraft. Go up. And this shouldn't. Oh, what the hell is wrong? Very strange behavior. There's still some villagers up there, but normally the villagers and the iron golems will drop down here. The villager, because they are only one block wide or less, will drop down and get killed right now. The iron golems will pass over this, will fall through the the signs and continue down the shaft. So this is one layer of the iron golem farm. There's another one, I think 69 or 70 blocks above this one. And these holes are the first how to call them, where I cured the villagers, the villager zombies, because at the end of this track, I don't know, power rails over here, at the end of this track there is a zombie spawner. It's a ladder towards the surface somewhere in the middle, and then maybe dark outside, or maybe there is some dark cave I haven't found before. Can't run anymore. Okay, let's run further. Almost there. I still got one villager zombie here. Yep. And here I have got the zombie spawner. At the moment it's completely lit up with some torches. Normally this room is pretty dark and the zombies will go down the water here and end up in this chain, I simply have to kill the normal zombies, keep the villager zombies, and transport those to there. Normally I don't use the system anymore because I had enough villagers over there, and even an infinite breeder system, but broken. So maybe I will use this again to put some more villagers up there, or simply have to gather them in one place, enough doors, and give them some food. So we're here at spawn, all the way to here. So there is my building. Where is my building? There it is. Voila. I'm not very happy with the towers at the moment. I may remove those and put some blocks like that, even over there, to make it more like a castle look. I'm not completely sure yet. But this was a short video showing you what I've been doing. Also, that building is finished. It was my community project, a farm. Not very big for the reeds and the pumpkins and the cacti and so on. But there is also two farms for wheat, one for potatoes and one for carrots down there. So it got us on our way. But yeah, I will end the video right here. Yeah, I hope that you enjoyed the quick, what's the word, the quick recap of what has happened around here. And who knows, maybe I will continue the series and try to do it less tutorial-like and talk more to you. Anyway, if you enjoyed watching this video, please leave a like. If you didn't, please leave a dislike. It doesn't matter. Just rate the video. And I will see you next time. Bye-bye.